Hello student, welcome to EPG Paathshala. I am Dr. Harin Ramsiari from Kirodimal College, University of Delhi. Today I am going to talk on module Life History and Reproductive Strategies Part 2 from the paper Principle of Ecology. Student will able to understand the concept of R and K selected species strategist. They will able to appreciate the opportunist equilibrium continuum as a different organizations and strategies to match the environment organisms live in and resources at their disposal to achieve the common goal, fitness. They will familiar with the contrasting attributes of R and K selected species strategist reflecting the trade-offs. They will able to distinguish R and K selection from R and K selected species. That is, concept of selection from the concept of strategist. They will understand how R and K selection works, working of the natural selection under the different combinations of physical environment and biotic factors. At the end, they will able to appreciate the world just cannot be divided into R and K species as the life exists as a continuum reflecting range of possible strategies with R and K strategist. At the opposite ends, and all organisms fall somewhere on this spectrum. On a hot summer afternoon, a gravid fruit fly lands on a inviting over a ripe banana thick with other flies. After probing the surface with her mouth parts for a while, she decided to lay eggs by next afternoon. Those tiny eggs have already hatched into larvae. For next 5 days, the larva feeds, digging deeper into the flesh, grow and shed their skin, molting twice inside the slowly liquefying banana. Females visit the fruit and lay eggs, but the first laid larva go on feeding and growing till its fifth day. On fifth day, larvae move out of the flesh and hide among the skin folds that they get ready to pupate. The encapsulated pupa stay inside their tough brown cylinders for the almost 6 days. It's morning on seventh day and a few plump white bodies adults are spotted. They emerge last night from their pupal skin and now are busy stretching their clumped wings. By afternoon, their soft and white body hardness and darkens and they are ready to make their life's first flight. Meanwhile, their 22 days old mother had laid more than 400 eggs into various fruit. She is busy again laying few more eggs on a rotting apple but accidentally slips into fruit sap. As she struggles for life, her wings got mired into fruit sap and she drowns. An hour later, her daughter visits the same apple, settles down and probes the skin with her mouth parts as she gets ready to deposit her first batch of eggs. The fruit fly is not alone in the league of animals leading such a fast-paced life. There are many others who believe this fast die young philosophy. In figure number first, you can see fruit flies on the banana. In another part of the world, a different story is going on. In a flimsy nest from twigs on a Christmas island, a red-footed booby chick is hungry again. It is 3 months old with an ever-increasing appetite and completely dependent on its parents. As usual, the food is in short supply, making rapid feeding of the chick impossible. The father gets ready to make another long trip to see. Flapping wings, it leaves the nest, rising on high wind of Indian Ocean to fetch food for the chick, passing the colonies of other relatives and feeding grounds of smaller birds. It carefully scans the water for flying fish, a favorite. Fortunately, it spots a few plung, dives and swallows. In the evening, it returns to a patent chick quite used to waiting for a meal. It opens the bill and regurgitates the swallowed fish to the chick. The chick grows and fledges after a few weeks. For another 6 months, the parents care for it. After 6 months, it makes its first extensive flight. 3 years passes as it learns the hunting skill of the catching of flying fish or squids, the main food, and those elaborate mating the rituals. Post acquiring the skill, it makes the first attempt to mate. It mates once after every 15 months, so lays a single egg after a successful mating. It mates and raises the first chick with the partner successfully. Next year, it returns to the same nest and mates with the same male. This year, feeding the growing chicks is becoming a progressively difficult task as the food supply is scarce. Assessing the food supply, one morning it goes back to sea along with its partner to ensure their own survival. The unfortunate chicks waits for the parents to return with the food. The chicks starves and dies. After 15 months, the female is back on the same nest trying its luck again. This time it successfully raises a chick. During its long life, it mates every 15 months and tries to raise a single chick each time. In this 21st year, it dies in a fishing accident. Only two of the seven chicks it has raised leave offspring that survive to reproduce themselves. In figure number 2, you can see Sula Sula, red-footed booby with its chick. R species and K species. The diversity of organisms on Earth is astonishing. The vivid life forms exhibit broad differences among their body size, lifespan, and reproductive partners. Irrespective of the life history patterns they show, all the organisms are adapted to gain fitness. Some are small, start reproducing at the young age, reproducing enormous number of offspring, and are short-lived, like the fruit fly. Others are large, postpone reproduction to the later age, produce few offspring, and long-lived, like the red-footed booby. The population of the former species grow rapidly within a short time span owing to different high reproductive rates, and progeny also start reproduction at the early age. On the other hand, population of later species grow slowly, rising few juvenile each time. Owing to other long lifespan, they can afford reproducing more than once in their lifetime. The population reaches and is maintained at a more or less stable size. Based on these features, Former species are referred as a R species and later as a K species. The idea of R K species is borrowed from the logistic equation of population growth, where the two terms R and K were used. In figure number 3, you can see R and K selected species population size graphical representation. The R species mostly represent the species inhabiting the marginal habitats with a hostile or unpredictable environment or resource, each ephemeral habitats. The acceptance of the high chance of the death under the such fluctuating environmental condition is rewarded in terms of resources. These species almost never faced any competition for the resources, as very few species inhabit such hostile habitats. When resources are in plenty and exponential population growth is possible, and that is exactly what these species practice when it comes to reproduction. They are called R species as they spend most of their lives in the either the exponential or near exponential R dominated phase of the population growth and never reaching the upper limit of carrying capacity. As the chances of the future survival are lean, investment in a growth or saving for the future reproduction would be futile effort. The organism tend to channel most of the resources into the reproductive effort, producing as many offspring as possible. The probability of juvenile survival under the hostile conditions is very low. Investing the heavy per offspring would not be the sound approach. Instead, a large crop of small size offspring ensure the survival at least a few. The short-lived, resources-rich environments with the favorable conditions lack competition, thus offspring size cannot be compromised. In both the scenarios, a small investment per offspring work well. The K species invariably depicts animals of settled existence with the favorable or stable environmental conditions. Such living conditions invite intense competition for the limited resources. The theory of natural selection predicts survival of fittest under the such crowding conditions. Fitness is the measure as a reproductive success. Only those individuals are successful in leaving the descendants that have captured the large share of resources. They win the battle of existence because they have grown faster and thus better competitors. The growth comes at the expense of the reproduction, which is delayed here. The natural selection favors packing of the resources into few but large offspring. The size of offspring is important as individuals have under crowded conditions facing intense competition for limited resources. Large offspring would be favored by the natural selection. With the fixed budget of energy, only few large offspring can be produced. They are called K species as their populations spend most of their lives in the K dominated phase of population growth near carrying capacity. Opportunist equilibrium continuum. The R and K species represent life at the two opposite ends. However, that does not necessarily means that R and K strategists cannot be found within the same species. In Trinidad, the guppies present in the different streams are preyed upon by the different predators, and those exposed to the different predators' selection process. The streams dominated by the chiseled fish, Cranichichelia alta, which preyed heavily on large mature guppies, harbored small size guppies, that mature faster, reproduce earlier and produce more and small size offspring than guppies from the streams were chiseled. Predator were, was absent and guppies faced lower predation. Further, guppies were experimentally moved from a site where they were preyed upon by the cranny chinchilla to a site where the both guppies and the predator cranny chinchilla were absent. After several generations, guppies were collected from the both the place of the origin and the introduction, and offspring were reared under the common laboratory condition. Guppies revealed of the cranny chinchilla predation exhibited delayed maturation and reproduction. Large adult size, fewer and large offspring. Clearly, the selection pressure resulting from the impact of the predation. Biotic factor is shaping the pattern of lifestyle R or K among the population of Trinidad guppies. In figure number 4, you can see the fish at the top, Cranny chinchilla alta, one of the key predators in the high predation localities. The middle fish, Rivivulus hereti, the only the predator co-occurring with the guppies in the low predation site. The fish on the bottom left and the adult male guppy on the bottom right, adult female guppy. Under natural condition, two of more populations or species exposed to a different selection pressure due to the effect of physical environment and various biotic interaction exhibit an additive combination of the history traits. Obviously, the two demand different organization and strategies to achieve the common goal, fitness. They're extremely opposed. Life history patterns or strategies are simply alternative ways to achieve fitness. It is also important to remember that life forms do not always exist at extremes. It is therefore logical to conclude that a range of compromise strategies is possible between two extremes. There are many species which show traits between the extremes of R and K. Therefore, a classification into R and K species or strategies is oversimplification of a more complex real world. In nature exists a continuous and variable spectrum or continuum of strategies between two extremes. This continuum of the strategies is called the opportunist equilibrium. The continuum describes a range of strategies from R to K observed among different species. All the living organisms are supposed to fall somewhere on this continuum between the two extremes, R and K. On the spectrum, as one moves from the R towards the K population, so a mix of R and K selected traits progressively becoming more K selected. Similarly, species populations relying more on R selected traits are met as one move from the K towards R. Thus, various species can be differentiated or grouped together based on their relative reliances on one strategy over the other. Even within species, RK strategies can be found among different populations. Example, guppies in Trinidad. In figure number 5, you can see R and K or opportunist equilibrium continuum. R strategies, a colonist, opportunist, generalist species. The marginal habitats are often inhabited by the organism which are bestowed with the high reproductive rates, R species. Their potential to multiply rapidly proves advantageous in environments that are short-lived. The organisms are skilled at making the best use of short but favourable periods, achieving the enormous population size which allows them to colonize new habitats quickly and exploit new resources. The other adaptations of such organisms help them to survive hostile periods which follow the infernal favourable times. Thus, there is a little or no time to invest to resources into growth and all the energy in focused on reproduction. These organisms are able to disperse rapidly. The ability to disperse help in invading the disturbed habitats after a catastrophe or colonized newly. Open habitats like temporary puddles or forest clearings or other remote habitats. These are the first ones to colonize only a new unoccupied habitat or arriving after the first disaster and therefore referred as colonized. As the environmental uncertainty poses a limit, species cannot be afforded to a picky in the therefore choice of food. Under such conditions, it is favorable to be a generalist, not specializing on one particular food for selecting purpose. Fitness here is achieved via producing large number of widely scattered progeny, as the chances of death are high during the unfavorable regions. These species are also known as a opportunist, as they take advantages of scarce and fleeting habitat. The harsh unfavorable environments were where other species cannot exist, or ephemeral yet favorable habitats both present an opportunity to establish populations. They have the life cycle properties favored by the natural selection to excel under such conditions. This kind of lifestyle is called opportunistic. Most of the short-lived animals of a high seasonal environments exhibit such life histories. Our strategist, as the fugitive species, there exists another possible explanation for residents of marginal habitats. Perhaps the dweller are not actual lover of these hearts of the ephemeral habitats, but all flitting away from other inhabitants of their original a much desirable of permanent environment. These opportunists can be looked upon fugitives running away from the competition existing at their actual desirable habitats and making the best whatever is left for them. The term fugitive species was introduced by Hudson 1951 to describe species which disperse quickly to colonize new habitats away from closer competitors. The Gauss competitive exclusion principle helps to understand the fugitive in a better way. The species having identical or highly similar resources requirements cannot coexist. Sooner or later, the stronger species will exclude the weaker species from the niche. The species which have been residing for a long in a habitat are adept and therefore better competitors than a recent introduction. The fugitive colonize new place without close competitors and disperse quickly to a new habitat as the competition arrives. The fugitive is also an opportunist, as it lives in a place where other cannot reach easily. The beautiful example of such fugitive species comes in the form of composed Erectomora. In 1927, it was noticed that only a one species of copepod was present in Oxford Municipal Sewage Works. However, in the local water bodies, other copepods were also present. The commonest copepods were of the genus Diptomus. The sewage works ponds were regularly drained and cleaned as they were part of filter system. The copepod Lucinulata was also the lone species in the brackish water of a river estuary near Liverpool. The same copepod was also present in other freshwater bodies where Diptomus was absent. Perhaps some other animals prevented E. Lucinulata from invading freshwater of the river. The E. Lucinulata existed by the efficient dispersal to the habitats where other competitors could not reach. It multiplied and survived as lone species till the competitors arrived, and then it quickly moved to another habitat, leading a fugitive life. It is an opportunist too, as it disperses with the ease quite efficiently, multiplied and survived as generalist as a places where other could not. Case strategist, equilibrium, competitors, specialist species. Life doesn't always exist in harsh environments. Life does flourish at the extremely fertile patches under the stable permanent environments. Obviously, these are the more desired habitats, and several species compete to secure a place for themselves. This leads to crowding. Species cannot afford explosive populations and maintain stable populations. The pursuit for the life under stable population is adaptations which help persistence. The population of such species tend to be equilibrium and thus also known as equilibrium species. The focus is on maintaining populations at or near K, the carrying capacity of the environment. Individuals face intense competition both within and among the species population. A large booby proves advantageous in the crowded habitat rather than the dispersal and high fecundity. Thus, these species are good competitors for said limited resources. Large size competitors have easy access to resources and acquire the greater share of it, therefore challenging energy resources into growth and maintenance is advisable rather than spending it on reproduction. As the most of the species are good competitors, to coexist the species occupying different niche and exhibit resource parsoning following Gauss principle, competitors cannot coexist. Resource parsoning or differential resource utilization refer to the difference in the manner a resource is utilized by different species. The species that coexist either eat different size and kind of food or feed at different times or different areas. This often leads to the specialization on particular food type, making them specialist species specializing on one or few food resources. Under such severe competition conditions, ensuring survival of young is more important than the producing enormous number of offspring. Competitors pays the toll of the terms of the reproduction. Competitors are conservative breeders and their fitness result from a longer lifespan is which they produces few youngs with a high survival probability. Parental care is another attribute of these species. The parental care is a good tactic under these conditions of intense intraspecific and interspecific competition, as it is likely to yield high return in surviving offspring. However, as a life rarely exists as a such extremis most of the organisms, so a mixed of RK species traits. Organism in struggle to make the best of the whatever is available to them, make compromises to also adjustments in various characters. Therefore, one way come across opportunist species, live under harsh environment and investing in parental care. Similarly, the fixed number of young produce clutch or litter size. Another attribute of equilibrium species cannot be a solution to unpredictable environment in certain cases. The Galapagos penguins have a fixed clutch size of 2 eggs. The food supply is highly unpredictable as it relies on ocean current. Usually a breeding efforts results in a failure to raise any chick. In table number 1, you can see some of ecologically important attributes of R and K strategies. Galapagos penguin, Galapagos Islands, Ecuador, the presents abundant both the chicks in the times of food scarcity. A successful breeding efforts result in rearing of the one chick. Penguins rarely raise of the two chicks, still invest to 2 eggs just to ensure survival of at least one is case of any accidental loss. Galapagos penguins are not the only exception, as most of the seabirds have the fixed clutch size and abandonment of chick is a usual phenomenon owing to fluctuating food supply. The large size, life, long lifespan, delaying reproduction and breeding survival times in the course of life and usually considered as attributes of K strategist. The sea turtle, including the olive green colored, olive redly, enjoying a long lifespan. You can see the you can see in figure number 7, olive redly. In figure number 8, you can see a hatchling making its first trip to sea. The olive redly lives for the 50 years. It grows slowly to a size of 65 to 70 centimeter. It's 13 years old, reaching sexual maturity when it makes first attempt to mate. The female, after a successful mating, lays around 100 eggs on the beach in a nest. After laying the eggs, it covers and leaves, investing no time to raising the young. Only a handful of fortunate young makes a successful trip to sea after hatching, as a gamut of hungry predators wait for them. Once in the sea, the survival battle continues, as there is no death of predators. A result of juvenile survival is slim. The female may compensate for this huge loss of nesting up to 3 times in a year. Thus, in real world, these are no hard and fast rule, as the organisms often employ a mix of R and K strategies to achieve the only a goal, fitness. R selection and K selection not synonyms with opportunist and equilibrium species. The concept of opportunist or the R strategist and equilibrium species or K strategist discussed so that refer to comparison made between species. There is another concept which may sound similar to the concept of R and K selection. The R and K selection describe processes acting within the species populations. Thus, the two terms R selection and K selection are not synonyms with the opportunist and equilibrium species. The term R and K selections were used first by the MacArthur and Wilson in 1967 in their Theory of Islands biography to distinguish between types of selection process and island colonist. Prior to the Wilson, 1961, while studying Michelson and coined the term taxon cycle to describe the inferred cycle evolution of species of Malthusian ant from the ability to live in a marginal habitats and disperse widely to preference for the more central species rich habitats with an associated loss of dispersal ability. And back again, Wilson 1961, the phenomenon mirrors the R and K selection operating in a cycle manner. R and K selection, the theory of MacArthur and Wilson 1967 explains how R and K selection operates. It described the colonization of a newly raised volcanic island from the sea by the different animal and plant species. The immigrants to the reach this island are opportunist or fugitive, gifted with the excellent dispersal mechanism. Once settled on the island, the opportunist achieve rapid population growth attributed to the high fecundity as they are descendants from the populations from the R selected. Consequently, in no time the island is crowded with their descendants, the species have to live in populations either at or near the saturation point K. The populations struggle to establish equilibrium, facing competition for the resources once unlimited or nearly so. As the immigrant species are not adapted to crowded lifestyle, natural selection tries to pick the most competitive variants from the island. Opportunist, begun a competitor means diverting the resources to traits which prove advantageous in the face of competition. This is the process of K selection. The K selection leads to attainment of sustained high density, a trait not practiced by populations showing R selection. The concept of R and K selection was successfully demonstrated in Drosophila population. In the wild, flies have a high fecundity and they need to disperse to find food. The population achieved equilibria when reared on culture medium under standard laboratory conditions. Crowded conditions demanded competition for fixed food supply. The irradiated flies to increase genetic diversity in population were better skilled as coping life under the crowded conditions than non-aerated control flies. How does it work? Organism acquire a limited amount of energy. They need to partition this energy between various life activities. They allocate energy mainly under the three budgets heads: maintenance, metabolic rate and survival, growth and reproduction. The prime importance is the core survival and maintenance, followed by the energy investment into growth and reproduction. The organism through natural selection try to find a favorable cost benefit ratio, as each of this activity bears some advantage and associated cost. The ration of energy allocated to maintenance and reproduction varies among species as well as among populations exposed to different living conditions. This ratio varies not only with the evolutionary history of a species and size of organism, but also with carrying capacity and population density. Thus, RK selection describes the working of natural selection under the different combination of physical environment and biotic factor. The concept explains the selection operating within the species populations, that is, how population starting off as an opportunist lead to an adaptive evolution of a more stabilized equilibrium population. An opportunist population, once settled in a marginal or recently distributed, achieved rapid population growth in no time. Once deserted habitat initially glimpses and later overflows with life. The overwhelming number of individuals, the descendants from the populations originally are selected opportunist, is not used to of a life under crowded conditions. As the environment is not going to crash, this homogeneous population down, natural selection picks the most competitive varieties from the existing opportunist. This is how RK selection works within a population. The term R and K strategist refer to strategies among species. Thus, the two concepts, selection and strategy, are not equivalent and should not be treated carefully. Summary: the opportunist species are well adapted to make best use to opportunist, both in time and space. The traits such as early reproduction, high fecundity, great dispersal abilities, short lifespan, etc., characterized their ready to take risk lifestyle. The fugitive species is also an opportunist, but on a run from competitors. Owing to other high biotic potential, these species tend to be flourish in uncertain or marginal habitats. Subjected to periodic stress, their ability to sit out when adversely hits and comes out of refugee to the recolonized or recently distributed habitat makes them resilient to perturbations. The equilibrium species are tough competitors as they live under crowded conditions. Their populations are at equilibrium. They are delayed reproduction and invest more into the growth and reproduction, produce few large young ready to face competition and enjoying a long lifespan. These species partition a large fraction of energy in favor of maintenance and competitive ability attributed to their crowded conditions. As a result of these bias, they perform better under stable environment and high density conditions. Near saturation K, they are good at competition but less resilient to the disturbances it is erroneous to think of world divided into either RK strategist. Life exists as a range of possible strategies, making few compromises or adjustment here or there. It would be better to imagine life as a continuum with R and K strategist. At the opposite ends, all the organisms fall somewhere on this spectrum. The R and K strategist represent species adopting different lifestyles attributed to different environment and a combination of various other biotic factors. The natural selection and uncompromising master forces all organisms, irrespective of their habitat, to strive for the fitness. The species occupying marginal habitat achieve it via high biotic potential. The natural selection under harsh or unpredictable environment favor individual investing into reproduction without wasting much energy into growth or survival. They are called R selected species as R is maximized. On the other side, desirable habitats invite more guests and hence intense competition. Natural selection favor organisms that compete better than others. Such species are called K-selected species. The R and K selection, another concept, works within a population. However, the natural selection process remains the same, selecting traits but within the population. Advantageous under present set of conditions. In the end, one must remember that the life, whether as R or K strategist or falling anywhere on the opportunist equilibrium continuum, is nothing but a struggle for the existence. Survival and leaving behind as many reproductively successful offspring as possible. Thank you.